It was so sweet of you, Nancy. I mean, coming by to wish me well on your way out of town.
Well, Barbara, I had such a wonderful 8 years in this lovely old home. I just wanted to wish you and George the... Wait a minute. You moved that vase.
What? Oh, yes, the Limoges. I suppose I did.
My dear, you can't be serious. A Limoges in that light? You can't see the detail. Now, I'm not going to tell you how to run the White House, but I have had about 8 years' experience more than you, huh? Let me just show you where I had it. I think you'll like it. Now, let's just get rid of this picture of George and the grandchildren. You know what they look like anyway. And voila, huh?
Well, yes. It's much better there. Thank you.
Well, I must admit I do have an eye.
When does your plane leave?
Well, whenever we get there. That's the wonderful thing about Air Force One.
Yes, but it won't really be Air Force One. That has to stay here for George and me. Sugar.
Lemon.
Thank you, Sarah.
Oh, those look lovely. Just
put them
down
over here.
Well, after 8 years, I feel like I still own the place. But of course, it is your house. For now.
Yes, it is.
And I notice you're using the Roosevelt tea service. I mean, don't you find it a little old-fashioned and dowdy? I much preferred the one that Frank and Barbara Sinatra gave to the White House.
Really? Well, I felt it was a little cold and lacking in charm, and I wanted to use an historical tea service for this occasion. The current First Lady says farewell to the outgoing First Lady.
And I am the outgoing one, am I not?
Excuse me, Mrs. Bush. Your appointment?
Oh, I hate to cut our tea short, but there's so much to be done.
Oh, my dear, I know. I mean, after 8 years and 2 inaugurations.
Well, yes, that's why I wanted you to be the first guest in my house.
Excuse me, the photographers are downstairs.
Tell them
I'll be right down. Well, Nancy, I really must go.
Oh, of course, I'll just stay here until I finish my tea.
Why, I wouldn't dream of leaving you alone, not even for 5 minutes.
Go on, you'll be late. I think I left a hat box upstairs anyway.
I'll go up with you.
No, I know exactly right where it is.
Well, just tell me where it is. George and I will mail it to you.
No, don't waste the taxpayers' money, Barbara.
Tom, would you escort Mrs. Reagan down to her limousine?
I don't really need an escort. No, Tom, I don't.
Well, what kind of a hostess would I be if I didn't see you safely escorted down to your car?
I think I can show myself out, Barbara.
Edward, could you come in here? Mrs. Reagan seems to be having trouble finding her way out.
Now, Barbara, really, don't worry about me. I think I can perfectly find my way out. I mean, this was my home for so long. You're going to miss your appointment, Barbara.
Well?
After all, the press can be very rude when you're late. I know.
Okay, let me help you, Mrs. Reagan.
No, I don't.
Mrs. Reagan? Okay.
Barbara,
let me help you.
I know you have to run. Don't be a stranger.
No, this will be fun.
Just write anytime. Well, you know the address.
Yes.
Give our love. Oh, dear, her purse. Tom, would you please return this to Mrs. Reagan? And don't let her out of her car.